Hi guys, in this video we are going to discuss SBRL, which is an abbreviation for Extensible Business Reporting Language. This is a topic of your CMA final CFR. It also comes in law and cost audit. So let's see what is XBRL or Extensible Business Reporting Language. Okay, Extensible Business Reporting Language. You might be aware of HTML. CSS, DHTML, MHTML, .NET, C#, etc. All these are computer programming languages, right? Likewise, there is a language called XML. It is a family of languages. And the one among the family of XML is XBRL. Okay. It is a language used for electronic communication. Of business data, and business includes financial also, right? So, XBRL is a language used for electronic communication of business and financial data. Okay, this is what XBRL is. What is XBRL? XBRL is a language used for electronic communication of business and financial data. Okay, now you are aware with the concept of XBRL. Now, let's discuss about these four terms: extensible, business, reporting, and language. What do you mean by extensible? Extensible means, if you go to Google and type in XBRL or XML, you get a sample data and it will have things like this. These are called tags. These are called tags. These tags helps to identify what data it is. What is the attribute of that data? What is the relationship of this data with another data? All these things are defined by these tags. Okay. So, with the use of these tags, we can extend the application of a particular data. Means this data can be used in multiple circumstances. Not only in one circumstance or situation, we can use this data in multiple circumstances. We can extend its applicability. That is what is called extensible. Okay, now business. This XBRL platform can be used to report the financial statements of any entity. Means there is no transaction which can't be expressed in XBRL reporting. Means every transaction can be expressed in XBRL reporting. And it is relevant for every kind of financial statement. That is what business is indicating. Reporting. The main idea behind promoting XBRL language is that all the entities will have a common platform for reporting the financials. Means all the financial statements will be in a uniform and consolidated and structured manner. That's the idea behind promoting XBRL, that is reporting. Now language. Like said earlier, XBRL is a language among the family of languages of XML, which is also a language used for electronic communication of data among businesses and on internet. Okay. In case you want these notes, you can purchase it from InstaMojo. Cost around only 10 rupees. It is a very detailed note, very simple to understand, and it is color note as well. I have included mnemonics. Okay, now coming to the next topic. Few important terms of XBRL. First term is XML. Extensible Markup Language. It is a markup language. Okay, it is a markup language. What is a markup language? Markup languages are used for identifying structures in a document. Markup languages are the languages used for identifying structures in a document. So we can say that it is a markup language for document containing structured information. So it is a language used for document containing structured information. What is this XML? This XML contains rules. This XML contains rules. And these rules convert information in a document to tags. This XML language convert the information contained in document to tags. These tags are both human readable and machine readable. These tags are both human readable as well as machine readable. That is what XML is doing. XML contain the rules for encoding the documents into a format which is machine readable as well as human readable. It is a textual data format. XML is a textual data format. Okay, now if you open this XML data or XML data document, you will see many textual data. That is why it is called textual data format. Okay, now it supports a wide variety of human languages. It supports a wide variety of human languages. The content in this XML document could be any language like Hindi or Tamil or English or anything. And it supports a wide variety of human languages. So what is XML? It is a markup language for identifying structures in a document. And it is a textual data format. It contains a rule for converting information into tags, which is both human readable and machine readable. Okay, this is what XML is. And earlier we were using HTML in place of this XML, and it is a limitation of HTML which forced us to use this XML. Okay, now coming to taxonomy. Okay, what is taxonomy? The concept of taxonomy. So, what is taxonomy? You might be aware with the concept of dictionaries, right? Dictionaries contains words and the explanation for such words. Likewise, taxonomy contains tags and definitions for these tags. Taxonomy contains a tag and definition for these tags. It contains not only tags, all the terms which are used in business reports are defined in this taxonomy. So we can say taxonomy is reporting area specific hierarchical dictionary. What is taxonomy? Reporting area specific hierarchical dictionary. So what is taxonomy? Reporting area specific hierarchical taxonomy. And for different purpose of or taxonomy differs according to the purpose of reporting. Means for sustainability reporting, the taxonomy may be different. For governance reporting, taxonomy may be different. For consolidated reporting, taxonomy may be different. So according to the purpose of reporting, taxonomy will differ. Likewise, taxonomies are different for different countries also. Indian taxonomy may not be same as US and Canada taxonomy. So taxonomy differs. It is a terms, a definition of terms. It is a consolidated definitions of terms explained in or contained in business reports. It is like a dictionary. It contains the definition of tags and terms used in business reports. And the purpose, according to the purpose of reporting, taxonomy also changes. Okay, they define the specific tags that are used for individual items of data, their attributes and their interrelationship. Different taxonomies will be required for different business reporting purposes. Okay, now some myths about XBRL. So there are some misunderstanding or myths which are in minds of common man, and we are going to analyze them here. Myths. The first myth is that XBRL is an accounting standard. First myth is that XBRL is an accounting standard. So one thing to note here is that XBRL is not an accounting standard. Accounting standards are the domain of what accounting standard centers like ICAI. XBRL is not an accounting standard. Rather, XBRL is a platform where content resides. We can store the content there. We can retrieve the content from there. That is what XBRL is all about. It is not an accounting standard. It is a chart of accounts. No, XBRL is not a chart of accounts. Rather, we use it to implement these type of things. It is not a chart of accounts. Okay, now, it is a gap translator. You may be aware of GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles. This GAAP also different. There is US GAAP, there is Indian GAAP, and some people believe that XBRL is something which is used to translate financial statements from one GAAP to another GAAP. No, XBRL is not a GAAP translator. You have to be thorough with that. It is not a GAAP translator. Now, it is not a proprietary software. Okay, many people believe it is a proprietary software. Proprietary software means you have to pay in order to use them. No, it is not a proprietary software. You don't have to pay any license fee for using XBRL. It is a freely available software and it is licensed for free use to public. There is no fees involved in using XBRL. Okay, now another thing is that many people believe it is a transaction protocol. No, it does not capture data at transaction level. It is not a transaction protocol. Rather, XBRL is a different standalone item. Okay, so it is not an AS, it is not a chart of account, it is not a GAAP translator, it is not a proprietary software, it is not a transaction protocol. These are some certain myths that are associated with XBRL. Okay, now, what are the features of XBRL? What are the features of XBRL? First thing, clear definitions. What is this? I said earlier, XBRL uses tags and it also uses taxonomies. These two things define a particular data contained in XBRL document. So, there is clear definition for each and every item contained in the XBRL document. So, it is the first and foremost feature, clear definition. XBRL allows creation of definition called taxonomies. Taxonomies contains the meaning of all terms used in business reports. Who developed these taxonomies? Okay, now we said that XBRL has taxonomy and taxonomies contain the definition for all the terms used in business report. And who developed these taxonomies? Taxonomies are developed by accounting standard setters or government agencies. Okay, they are developed, or regulators. Even regulators can formulate taxonomies. Okay, they are the ones who are formulating taxonomies. Okay, and there is no limit. Okay, XBRL does not restrict the limit of things to be included in taxonomy, or XBRL doesn't say only certain type of tax or terms can be used, and nothing like that. You have unlimited choices with XBRL. So that is what clear definitions is about. Next is testable business rules. You might have used Excel, right? In Excel, we will be using many formulas. Some may be logical formulas, some may be mathematical formula. Likewise, in XBRL also, we can use these rules. And XBRL allows creation of rules. These rules can be either mathematical or logical. This helps to identify areas of problem, or it also helps poor quality information from being sent or received, etc. Okay, and it also helps in creation of ratios, etc. So that is a testable business rules. Now, multilingual support. The first phase itself we said XBRL support a wide variety of human languages, right? So multilingual support. The data in XBRL can be converted into another language without any extra effort. Okay, that is what multilingual support is. Now coming to strong software support. XBRL is a freely licensed software. Okay, you don't have to pay any license fee in order to implement XBRL into your information system or module or package. Okay, so XBRL has a huge software support from small to large vendors. It doesn't matter. Okay, whether the vendor is small or large, they can implement XBRL very easily. That is what strong software support is. So features, clear definitions, testable business rule, multilingual support, and strong software support. Okay. Now, benefits of XBRL reporting. I have formulated a mnemonic for this. MAT improved IT cost. So what is it? Benefit. First one, more accurate and efficient. With the use of taxonomies and tags, XBRL helps to report the financials more accurately and more efficiently. That is what more accurate and efficient is about. A for automatic data processing. What is this automated data processing? Means, in case you are filing some information to government agency, okay, through XBRL, then the clerical work involved in such filing is very much less. Okay, if you think from the government angle also, the clerical work will be very much less. Means the data will be received and processed automatically by the software itself. There won't be any manual data entry and all those stuffs. It will be automatic data processing. Now D, data review. Earlier itself we said it allows creation of rules. With the help of these rules, we can identify a problem areas, and we can ask our accountant or auditor to review what the problem is. That is what data review is. Now, improved reporting quality. Using of XBRL will bring some uniformity and structure to the financial statements, which in turn increases the transparency and uniformity. Okay, and it will help us in what more effective comparison also. That is what improved reporting quality is about. Now IT, interchangeable. Now imagine an organization A and imagine B, and okay, let's say example, Tata Ford. They use the software A, Ford uses software B, income tax department uses software C. They file returns in XBRL format, and income tax software also process XBRL. Means it doesn't matter what software package you are using. If you are using XBRL, it can be used interchangeably in any software packages. That is what interchangeable is. It can be used interchangeably in any information system. Okay, irrespective of the entity. Now, T, use of tax or tagging of transactions. XBRL uses tags to for each individual data, and it helps to validate the data, and it also helps in presentation and interpretation of the data. That is what tagging of transactions is about. Now, cost and time savings. When we compare XBRL technologies to other technology, the cost of storing, receiving, what process processing, auditing of XBR related technology is very much what cost effective and time saving. Okay, that is what cost and time saving is. So MAT improved IT cost, more accurate and efficient, automatic data processing, data review, improved reporting quality, interchangeable tagging of transaction, cost and time saving. Okay. Now, the uses of XBRL. Companies use XBRL. Non-profit organizations use XBRL. All these people have accountants. They also use XBRL. Accountants prepare various reports for regulatory authorities. These regulatory authorities may be stock exchanges, security regulators, business registrars, financial regulators, etc. Besides regulators, they prepare reports for government agencies. They prepare reports for tax authorities. Now comes from certain external parties, investors. Now analysts. Specific data providers like CRISIL, credit rating, statistical authorities. These are the uses of data. Okay, now I just connected in order for easy remembering only. Okay, these are the uses of XBRL. Okay, these are the uses of XBRL. Company, NPR, accountant, regulatory authorities, stock exchanges, security regulators, business registrars, financial regulators, government agencies, tax authorities, investors, analysts, specialists, data providers, and statistical authorities. Okay? Hope you are familiar with it. Hope you are understood. Getting it or not? Now, the XBRL is managed by an entity. It is a not-for-profit association. It is a not-for-profit global association called the XBRL International Incorporated. XBRL International Incorporated. It is called the XBRL International Incorporated. XBRL is managed by this entity. And it operates through XBRL Steering Committee. They have a committee called XBRL Steering Committee and it operates through it. They manage this XBRL International Committee. What they do is they do develop taxonomies. They develop taxonomies and they work closely with government, stock exchanges, companies and various regulators in order to support and promote the adoption of XBRL. Okay, and they have an Indian jurisdiction which is called XBRL India. And they work closely with Indian government, SEBI, RBI, MCA, etc. And their efforts led AMCA, SEBI and RBI to adopt XBRL for their reporting. Okay, so this is what XBRL International and XBRL India is about. Now, applicability of XBRL reporting. All listed companies in India and their Indian subsidiaries. All listed companies in India and their Indian subsidiaries have to report in XBRL. Now, in case of unlisted companies, if their paid up share capital is greater than or equal to 5 crore or if their turnover is greater than or equal to 100 crore, they have to do XBRL reporting. This criteria you can see in audit committee section 177 of Companies Act, also the same criteria, only the public deposit criteria are removed. So all listed company and their Indian subsidiary, the paid up share capital greater than or equal to 5 crore, turnover greater than 100 crore, or any other company. Okay, any other company as may be prescribed. Now certain companies are excluded from the this requirement. They are insurance companies, banking companies, power, NBFC. These companies are excluded from the requirement of XBRL reporting. This won't come under
Companies Act.
Okay, this is what applicability is all about. Now, second some miscellaneous items. Cost audit report is also filed in the filed through XBR. Okay, cost audit report is also filed through XBR. Keep that in mind. Then, in case of RBA, base 2 reporting norms. Also, it also supports XBRL. Now coming to SEBI, SuperD. SEBI Unified Platform for Electronic Reporting and Dissemination. This is also an XBRL platform. Now BSE, Bombay Stock Exchange. They have also adopted XBRL for governance reporting and shareholder pattern reporting. Okay, this is all about the XBRL chapter. This is a very important chapter. So prepare thoroughly this chapter. CFR, this could make a difference between pass or fail. So in case you want these notes, we can download it from the link below. It's an InstaMojo link. The price comes around to 10 rupees only. Okay, thank you, all the best, happy learning.